It is a very human tendency to assume things which are not true. I assumed that this video was going to be sponsored by AMD, but I just found out that that is not the reality. You may also assume that you don't need a laptop with an MPU, but today we are going to show you why you may be wrong about that. I would like to thank AMD for flying us from the beautiful city of Udaipur to the city of traffic Bengaluru. They hosted us at their big high-tech office and explained how beneficial it is for them when people buy their new AI PCs. I also personally set up the different AI applications and the language models that we will test out today. Now, we have been seeing this new type of chip called neural processing unit in some devices for over a year, but not everyone is a tech nerd, so you might not have noticed this. An NPU is a chip that is specifically designed to accelerate AI and machine learning tasks. Since it is much more specialized than a GPU or a CPU, using it is more efficient and faster for AI tasks. We are seeing new uses for these chips every month, but this is still kind of an early implementation for these chips. So today we are going to explore what are the real life benefits and how much difference having this new chip actually makes. We are also going to have this 6th generation Ryzen Pro laptop in our comparison, so you will be able to see how much of a difference you will get with these new AI PCs versus an older laptop that you may already have. First, let's talk about some features that are only available on these new kinds of laptops we are calling AI PCs. The latest version of Windows has the new Copilot Plus features that are just not available on devices without an NPU. The most useful feature for me has been Click to Do, which allows me to select text even from the images on your screen. You must have already been using this on your phone, but now it is also available on AI PCs. Another very useful feature is the semantic search in Windows, which lets you search files based on their content. For example, I have this folder with different images. I have renamed them to just be numbers, and we also don't have any metadata in these files that explains what the content is. Still, when you search for words like horse, cat, animal, flower, Lisa, Sue, you will get the image files containing that subject in the results, and this just makes life so much easier because you may have to go through thousands of images from your phone to find that one weird thing that you want to show to your friend. The new contextual search in settings also lets you find out the exact setting that you need to change instantly without needing to dive deep into the menus. By the way, all of these features work while the device is offline too, so you don't have to connect to the internet for these features. Having an NPU makes it possible to run many AI tasks locally, so if you are concerned about your privacy, this is a great feature. Another Windows Copilot Plus feature is Recall, which generates snapshots of the work that you are doing, so in case you want to revisit what you did last week, you can easily do that. Think of it like browsing history, but for the entire operating system instead of just your browser. Now, this feature should ignore your incognito tabs and other sensitive things, so you should be able to browse adult content on your AI PCs without any worries. At least on laptops, it is still not mandatory to install that Sanchar Sathi app. You must have seen the live captions working on your non-AI PC, but the AI PCs also support live translated captions even when you're offline, and let's check this demo for that. Dono options literally the best hain. Dono monitors almost identical hain, sirf ek difference ye hai ki PXF model mein ek kafi better stand milta hai jisme har tarike ke adjustments hain aur isme inbuilt speakers bhi hain. Is review mein main mostly PXF model show karunga, lekin dono basically same monitors hi hain. The Windows Studio also features some effects like blurring the background and auto-framing while utilizing the NPU, and for these tasks, you could use your GPU with some other similar apps, but that will not be as power efficient, which is super important for long video calls. These tasks actually use the NPU, as you can see here. I also tried testing these features after disabling the NPU using the device manager, and these features stopped working. I have read some reports that Microsoft is trying to make these features work on PCs without an NPU too, but I am not sure when or if that is going to happen, and by then we may already see new features that are exclusive for the AI PCs. For example, we already have features like Relight and Super Resolution in the pipeline for AI PCs, which let you do advanced photo editing directly through Windows. It's almost 2026. And I am sure that you must be having great fun with generating weird images with Google Nano Banana Pro, but you can also generate images locally with apps like Amuse AI that use stable diffusion models. Amuse AI allows you to run image generation on either the NPU or the GPU, so I tested how much of a difference there is in the speed and efficiency on the AI PC, and while using the NPU, the same task was done in 60% of the time while consuming 66% less energy. This means that when you do the same task with the NPU, it delivers almost 3 times the performance per watt compared to doing it on the GPU. When it comes to laptops, it's all about the efficiency, and having something that is 3 times as power efficient will really change how long you're even able to work, so we really see a huge advantage with the addition of the NPU. The older non-AI PC just couldn't generate the image at the same resolution, and even after reducing the available memory, we got a result that was totally unusable, but you could argue that it does kind of look like a modern art mosaic. Do give this video a thumbs up for the environment, because we just saved 75 ml of water by generating these images locally. Now that is it for image generation, but you all must use ChatGPT, and I was also surprised by how capable the large language models which you can run locally on your laptop are. The Lemonade server allows us to do many of the simple tasks that you would have to use a cloud-based LLM for, and I tried to generate a 1000-word essay on our beloved mosquitoes, and we found that even though the NPU was slightly slower than using the GPU, it did consume around 13% less energy. The GPU is more suited for LLM workloads, so I am not surprised that it was faster, but in addition to saving 13% of the energy with an NPU, having it also keeps the GPU free for other tasks, and the GPU in this Ryzen AI PC is quite powerful, but you may not need something like that for LLM tasks if you have an NPU. The older non-AI PC was 60% slower than our AI PC, even though it did use a slightly different language model that shouldn't affect the speed of our results. I have to clarify that even though I have an LLM degree, I am not an AI expert, so I have tried to keep these tests as objective as possible, but there may be some errors, so if you have been able to spot anything, you can let me know in the comments and we can argue about that. HP's AI laptops also come with their AI companion app, which you can use to generate local libraries by uploading your own files and then asking the AI questions about it even while you are offline, and this is so great because you don't need to set anything up separately. You can also use this app to ask support questions that are specific to your device. You can control some basic settings. It of course lets you know if everything is updated on your laptop, and there's also an AI optimization feature which I didn't try. So with all of this, you have seen how useful the NPU can be for general users and for people who have some very specific needs. I am not sure how many of the Windows Copilot Plus features would come to non-AI PCs, so they are a real advantage for now, and tasks like image generation also showed a big advantage with an NPU in our tests. I am still not saying that you should go out and rush to buy a new laptop with an NPU now, because I understand that the use cases shown today may not be relevant for everyone. But what we are seeing today is that the NPU has become a component that has started being utilized for various common and niche features, and in the future, we are sure to see it being utilized by more apps. I had also shown some NPU based AI features in apps like Premiere about a year ago. So if you're in the market for buying a new laptop, it definitely makes sense to go for an AI PC over a non-AI PC. In addition to the energy efficiency in some tasks, you will also miss out on some cool features in many apps if you don't have an NPU. But let me know what you think about the state of NPUs in the comment section. I will have the links to check the devices featured today in the video description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.